I'm Bart Boehlert from Bart Boehlert's Beautiful Things, and today we're in Cooperstown, New York. We're at the Fenimore Art Museum, which is on the shore of Otsego Lake, which is really beautiful. At the Fenimore Art Museum today, we're going to see an exhibition of portraits by John Singer Sargent. I'm really excited to see it. Sargent is one of my favorite painters. He was born in Florence in 1856. His parents were American, but he always lived and worked in Europe, and he died in London in 1925. He is most well known for his portraits. He painted 900 oil paintings in his life and 2,000 watercolors, almost 3,000 works of art. Going to meet with Dr. Paul D'Ambrosio, who is vice president and chief curator and chief organizer of this exhibit. There's also a costume exhibit that goes with the show, so I'm really looking forward to this. Here we are with Dr. Paul D'Ambrosio, vice president and chief curator here at the museum, who's going to take us through the show. So why don't you tell us a little bit about the idea behind it?
Well, we have had John Singer Sargent on our shortlist of great American artists to feature here at the museum for quite some time. And when I was thinking about how to start this project a couple of years ago, it occurred to me that there had never been a museum exhibition of Sargent's portraits of women. Fashion an exhibit that shows Sargent's whole career, but I think in particular how through his whole life he was affected by, influenced by, and fascinated with women.
Great. Good, okay. Let's have a look.
It's a portrait of Mrs. Abbott Lawrence Roach. She lived in Boston, but she was originally from Savannah. And she seemed to prefer the very ornate style that Sargent loves to use, that harkened back to the 18th century Rococo Baroque portraits. But what it really shows is how good Sargent was in terms of not just characterization and composition, but just the masterful brushwork that he used to embellish his portraits of women. This is Lady Eden, and actually she's better known for her son, Anthony Eden, who was Prime Minister of Britain in the 19-teens. But in the very early years of the 20th century, 1906, Sargent painted her portrait in London. She lived in one of the great neoclassical mansions in England. And so in this portrait, partly, I would imagine, in response to the decor of the surroundings, Sargent using a much tighter, more controlled, much more neoclassical, idealized style than the elaborate Baroque style we saw in Mrs. Roach. He also, one of the reasons why he was so popular, he had this London studio that was immense and loaded with props. All of the furniture that you see, the furnishings in these, in this portrait in particular, are Sargent's studio props.
Interesting.
That he used and that she must have approved. So he could, you could come into his studio, he could set you up with any, you know, all manner of furnishings and settings. You can be here for a lot longer than 6 or 7 minutes. This is Mrs. Henry Marquand, Elizabeth Marquand. It's really a very important picture, probably the most important picture in terms of Sargent's career in the United States. He had, as you know, created a major scandal in 1884 with his portrait of Madame Boutreau, Madame X.
Right.
And subsequently, he had some difficulty getting business. So in a sense, Sargent, when he came to America, at the request of the Marquands, Henry Marquand was a banker, and they had a home in Newport, he sought to assure the American audience that he was respectable, and that he could paint respectable portraits. And so when he came to the U.S., it was 1887, he painted the most conservative portrait he could possibly create. Beautiful characterization of the dignity of age, in a sense. She's an aging woman, but beautiful in her own way. So he got many, many commissions as a result of this portrait. This one in the middle is my favorite in the exhibition.
This?
Yes. It's a pretty, it's a very small, unassuming picture. But I think it speaks for something far grander. Sargent in this exhibition, we see a lot of commissioned portraits of society women. He also had a great liking for women that were exotic in this time.
Uh-huh.
And he traveled to Capri in 1878, and he found this young woman from Capri, a 16-year-old girl, in fact, Rosina Ferrara. I like this picture because, unlike the portraits of the women that we have been looking at, he is painting this young woman purely for her feminine beauty and a sense of mystery that we have looking at someone that's from a different culture. It shows another take on Sargent's fascination with women.
Yeah.
His friend Frank Hyde, the English artist, introduced them, and he was so grateful to Hyde that he gave his first sketch of Rosina as a present and souvenir of company.
Nice
souvenir.
Nice gift, yes. Madame X was the very controversial painting that Sargent painted in Paris. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
This is a very interesting subject, and of course it was one of the defining moments of his career. Madame Gautreau was a celebrated beauty. She had come from Louisiana. Her father died in the Civil War. Her mother brought her and her sister to Paris, married them off to wealthy Parisians. She married a wealthy banker, Pierre Gautreau. So Sargent deliberately sought her out the way that he sought out Rosina Ferrara in Capri. And so he pursued her, and he eventually won the commission. And he labored over this portrait for months and months because it was so difficult to capture in his own mind how to portray her. And so he chose a full-length portrait with her in profile. Of course, it created an incredible scandal for a lot of reasons. First of all, there was a lot of flesh shown. That dress is also a lot of skin. That dress is very tight.
And the strap was coming off her.
The strap on her right shoulder originally was seen as falling off. It was his one concession to decorum after the Salon exhibition was to paint it back up.
But it didn't help.
No, at that time the genie was out of the bottle.
Right.
He was vilified for months. Her mother stormed his studio that night and said he had ruined her. My child is lost, she said. My people will be forced to fight. I mean, that implies maybe even a duel.
I want to talk about this painting because it's different from the styles of the others. It looks impressionistic to me. It looks like Monet.
Correct.
So maybe you could talk about this.
This is Two Girls with Parasols. It was done in 1888. It's in the collection of the Metropolitan. And you're exactly right. It shows how Sargent mastered the impressionist style, the way he mastered neoclassicism, the Baroque, the international portrait style that he helped develop. He had painted with Monet in 1885, and so he knew impressionism from the master. But it shows how adaptable he was and how he was able to assimilate those styles and techniques and create absolutely beautiful pictures within just a few years of that encounter. The other thing that's important about this is that it's his sister Violet. And the important thing to remember about Sargent is that he lived his life surrounded by women that he just adored, of course.
I love the colors and the light.
Very, very different colors. The pastel coloration, the dappled light captures it magnificently.
It was this that her bow has attracted my attention.
Doesn't it, though? This is Madame Scudier. Her husband Paul was a politician in Paris and a great friend to the artists. And so Sargent knew her in his early days in Paris, and he paints this striking, handsome woman, but with this such a perky expression, such happy, lively, just this portrait is so full of life. Inflection of striking red hair, and then this ribboned bonnet, which just speaks volumes about her sense of fashion, about her wanting to get attention.
It's very jolly.
Very, very, extremely.
Perfect, Chris. Perfect.